Hi, folks. Did you hear about the couple who got married so late in life that Medicare picked up 80% of the honeymoon? Let's see what Ginny Palmer can help us with Sarah Young and help us make the great connection and help us stay there and help us stay away from ourselves and realize how things really are. Good morning. March 15th, the old income tax day. Remember when March 15th was income tax day? Okay, touch screen. Hello. Oh, no, I see, that's too bad. I used to know a number, now I don't know it because of touchscreen. Because of... Praise ye the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation. Praise Him, my soul, for He is thy strength and salvation. All ye who hear, to His temple draw near. Join us in glad adoration. Well, really, Glendora, I don't think this is so difficult to find Ginny Palmer, Madeline Chapin. There's Ginny Palmer. I have started a new lecture, listening to a new lecture series, Neuroscience in Everyday Life, the brain in everyday life. Hi, Ginny. It's Glendora, honey, and it's
your... All right, I got my radio turned up really loud. Wait a minute. I listen to Christian music.
Listening to Christian music.
Yeah.
Join us in glad adoration.
That's how I get through my day sometimes when I'm working. I listen to the music.
Oh, yeah, that's very helpful.
Yeah.
It's a wonderful thing. It's the God inside of us, music. That and laughter and sense of humor.
Yeah, that's what this tells us. Let's see. Tomorrow, I think, is the one that talks about laughter. Listen to the love song that I am continuously singing to you. I take great delight in you. I rejoice over you and sing it. The voice of the world are the sound of chaos. Pulling you this way and that way. Don't listen to those voices. Challenge them with my word. Learn to take many breaks from the world, finding a place to be still in my presence and listening to my voice. There is immense hidden treasures to be found through listening to me. So I pour out blessings upon you always. Some of my richest blessings have to be active thoughts. I love to reveal myself to you. And you seeking heart opens you up to receive more of my disclosure. Ask and it will be given to you. Seeking you will find. door will be open to you. And they gave inscriptions that the Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing.
Nice.
And then we got Matthew said, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door will be open.
Yes.
Yeah. He said, listen to the love song that he sings to us.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very nice, isn't it?
Yes, it is. He's there all the time. That's why you can live by yourself and not feel lonely. Because you know you have somebody with you, you know?
Absolutely. He's there all of the time, and we should be there all of the time.
Yeah, well, I was just singing to him myself.
Good.
I rise up with as I wait for him, I rise up with the wings like eagles, and I will soar with you. Your spirit leads me on by the power of your love. I'm not singing too good with my voice, but it's cold, but I sing to him anyway.
Yeah, that's a very good hymn.
And you know, when I sing that, I can picture myself up in the sky, just floating and being free and not earthbound, you know?
Mm-hmm.
The spirit can just take you right up.
Yep.
Take you out of this whatever's going on, you know?
Yep.
That's what's so good about it. Yeah. He speaks a lot about with eagle's wings, you know?
Yep.
So, that's one of the things I like. I like it to sing that one, you know?
Yes.
So when I sat here and I turn my heart towards the Lord, I just sing whatever comes to my head. You know?
You what?
If you just sit quiet and you're just meditating on the Lord, something will come to you. It'll just come to you.
Good for you.
Yeah, that's when I sit and I just think about.
It is true.
Yeah, and then I never know what I'm going to sing because it just comes. And that means he's right here with me.
And you're right there with him.
Yeah. Thank the Lord. We've got a lot to be thankful for.
Indeed.
So many people never learn this.
What can we do for them?
And they don't know what they miss.
What can we do for them?
Pray. Set example. That's all you can do.
Yeah.
You know, when John was going through so much trouble, I used to, I asked the Lord one day, what can I do to change John? And he says to me, you're not in the changing life business. I am. So, and you know what? The church that I was going to at the time told me to throw him out, tough love. You know, that'll straighten him out. And I went to the Lord about it. What should I do? And the Lord told me to love him.
Yeah.
Not to uphold him, but to love him.
Yeah.
And that's just what I did. And John has told me since then, Mama, if you'd let go of me, I couldn't have made it.
Really?
Yeah. So see, God knows what to do. You can't always get counsel from people that don't know. You know, they just told me what came out of their head. They didn't tell me what they prayed about and what God told them, you know?
Right.
So you can't take counsel from everybody.
No.
You can only take counsel from the people that's connected.
Right.
Yeah, I learned that, you know. If I need wisdom, I know who to go to, you know? John and I had some tough years, but, you know, it was because he got hurt so bad. He didn't know what to, he was young and didn't know what to do with his hurt, you know? So he tried the things of the world to get rid of his hurt, you know?
Yes.
Cover it up. It's not a solution for hurt, you know?
No, you can't cover it up.
No, he tried to cover it up with all kinds of stuff and only made trouble for himself and his wife, you know?
Yep.
Thank the good Lord that he don't give up on us, you know?
Yep.
He didn't give up on John. He loved him and he told me to love him. I never stopped loving him. He's my kid, you know?
Cool, that's
it. How these people stand it when their kids get executed and stuff like that. You know, that happens so much.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. How can you deal with that, you know? I don't know. I hope I never have to find out, right? So what are your thoughts to today?
Up to today, I think Dorothy German could use some attention and affection, and so I'm going to take her to the trolley line, I think.
Yeah.
And we're going to have steaklets and mashed potato and gravy and green beans.
Oh, well, that sounds like a good lunch.
Yeah. That's the kind of lunch you give me. Yeah.
I'm making tacos.
What?
And red tacos.
Oh.
And red beans and rice.
Oh.
Yeah.
Any onions in the red beans?
Well, yes, there is. Yeah.
That's good. That's what they call beans and rice.
Yeah. I make beans and greens sometime too to carry to the gathering place. I bet you'd like those.
What
you
is
know
it?
What I do? I get these dried beans in the package.
Yes.
And I soak them overnight.
Yes.
And I cook them the next day. And when they get done, I add a whole bag of spinach to them.
Wow.
And they're really good. Beans and greens.
Well, now, beans and greens. Now, what do you put in for flavoring?
I use salt and pepper and margarine.
I see.
That's all I use.
Yeah, that would be delicious.
Yeah, it is. And it's, you know, the beans are good for you.
Oh, of course. And so it's
especially if they don't have all that sugar and stuff over them. These are just plain beans, you know?
Oh, I want those. Yeah, you going to make me some?
I will one of these.
I
use the pinto beans a lot.
You know,
they're the red beans.
Yeah, that's a perfect vegan dish. All it is greens and beans, salt and pepper, and margarine.
Yeah, yeah.
So count me in on the next one, please.
Okay, because I always make a lot. A pound of beans make a lot.
Oh, they do. Oh, they do, yeah.
And then I get a big bag of spinach and put in it, you know.
It just takes one bag?
Yeah.
And how long do you cook the spinach?
I just finished the spinach and the beans. I put them right in the beans and finished cooking them right in that. You know?
And how long do you cook them after that?
I don't time things, you know. I just know when they're done. I've cooked for so many years. The beans take half a day to cook after you soak them overnight.
Oh, they do. But how long does it cook the spinach? Oh, see, that's what I was looking for.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that would be delicious, yes.
Yeah. I'll see about making us some next week.
Oh, good.
My groceries all bought for this week, so.
And serve them with 12 grain bread.
Yeah. I like this bread. It's, I don't know what the name of it is. It's got all kinds of grains in it. It's called peasant bread.
Yeah, it isn't German rye, is it? Very thick and very thick, hard and dry.
Yeah, I like that bread with them. It's so hearty.
Yes, it is.
I got a loaf of it now. It's let's see what it's called. It's Walter grain, all natural.
Yes.
And it's, pronounce it? Heidelberg or something.
Heidelberg? Heidelberg?
Yeah.
Heidelberg.
And it's all natural.
Mm.
And it's all got multiple grains. And it's really good. It's even good with toast. I don't like soggy bread, you know. I like it really, it was soft.
Save the package for me and I can get it at the store. Really?
And it fills you up too.
Oh, sure. Body, sure, yeah. Your body's very grateful for you for giving it something nutritious.
Yeah.
No, that beans and greens is an ideal meal.
Yeah, yeah.
I wish I had it to take tomorrow night to my vegetarian club.
What?
Beans and greens.
Oh, beans and greens.
Do you have the ingredients in the house now to make beans and greens?
I have beans, but I don't have the spinach.
Are you going out today?
No. That's why I told you next week, because I buy groceries I've been buying them on Sunday and Monday.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't only go once a week.
Did you go yesterday?
I went Sunday, because I didn't want to go out in the rain yesterday.
Oh, okay. Did you go by yourself?
I went Sunday. Huh?
Did you go by yourself?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I did. Well, the last 2 weeks I didn't. Michael and Carlotta and us went together. But last week, Carlotta's sick. She's got a cold. She says she thinks she's got pneumonia. And so she went home from church, and then I came home and had lunch, and then I went shopping by myself, you know.
Oh.
But, I'll get it for you for next week. You got it every Wednesday, right?
No, honey. It's only now the second Wednesday and the last Wednesday.
Oh, yeah.
But this month it had to be the third Wednesday because of the Church of the Covenant where we have it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the last Wednesday.
They used to tell you to bring soup.
What?
We used to bring soup. My sister made cabbage soup. They love that cabbage soup over there.
Sure.
Cream of cabbage soup?
Yeah, where do you eat?
Where do you what?
Where do the people eat the soup?
In the back there, they have liver lunches. Is that what you're talking about? The liver lunches that they have over there?
Who?
Or the Church of the Covenant.
Oh, no. Oh, yeah, the Lenten lunches. Oh, sure, yeah. Now I know what you're talking about. Yeah, they're having them right now.
Yeah, my sister, they always asked her to make the cream of cabbage soup.
Boy.
And everybody loved it. And she couldn't serve it, so I used to go and serve it for her.
Oh.
And we made a great big pot of cream of cabbage soup.
Yep.
See, if you went with milk, I could make you that, too.
Yeah. They have terrible sandwiches. They have ham and bologna, ham and cheese, and awful sandwiches, tuna fish, and all this junk.
Yeah, I know. It was very hard for me to have anything to eat. But somebody used to make cream cheese and olives, and I used to eat that, you know. But I know it wasn't much for me to eat.
It would much better to have your Heidelberg bread.
Yeah, well...
Lettuce and tomato in your Heidelberg, that's what they need. Lettuce, tomato, and your Heidelberg bread.
Yeah, that's what I had for lunch, and it was really good. It was, you know... I found these tomatoes that taste like tomatoes.
Where?
They're little. They're small, but they have the flavor of a summer tomato.
You sure?
Yes, I buy them all the time. And I got two or three more people that's starting to buy them.
What are they called?
Campari, and they tell you on the package that they're tomatoes, loves tomatoes, and they taste like tomatoes. They're small, but they really taste good, and I buy them all the time.
Hannaford's?
Yep. Yeah.
Well, I'm glad to have a tomato at last. It tastes like a tomato. That's gone for 20 years.
Well, I found these out last year. And then I found out that I told a couple of my friends, and they started buying them. And they said, you know, these tomatoes are so good.
Well, good.
And I took them to the gallon place in the salad. And somebody said to me, now, how did you get tomatoes that taste like tomatoes?
Yeah.
And I said, well, you got to buy. You gotta buy this brand.
It Campari.
Yes. And it says on it that the tomato loves tomatoes.
What about Jean Miller?
I haven't been to her because I'm still coughing my head off.
Did you call him up?
I've been talking to her friend. I can't get her on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
No, I've been talking to the lady that,
Is she coming home? Is she coming home?
I don't know what's happening right now. Last I heard, she was thinking about staying there. But Marge was in church Sunday. Did you hear me?
Who?
Marge.
Marge was in church Sunday?
Yeah, she was. She's living with Pastor, and Pastor brought her.
Wonderful.
Yeah, we all went and talked to her. She's looking pretty good.
Oh, wonderful.
So?
Well, that left much farther ahead than we anticipated.
Yeah, well, she's going to have good care because Diane will take good care of her.
Oh, wonderful.
She looked pretty good.
Good.
Yeah.
Good news. Thank you. No, you didn't tell me that.
Yeah, she was in church Sunday.
Okay. Now, I have something to tell you. The Lutheran Church, St. Luke's in Valencia, has a community meal every Tuesday night, January, February, and March. And over approximately 130 people come every Tuesday night.
Yeah.
And a different church does the meal every Tuesday night. And on March 22nd, the Seventh-day Adventists are going to do the meal. And I asked Donna Fowler, in charge of it, what she was going to have. And she said spaghetti and meatballs, meaning Gardein. Gardein is a vegan meatball. So I said, well, Donna, I've gone to these suppers for 4 years, and spaghetti and meatballs pops up about 6 or 7 times a year. Can we do something different? Of course, it has to be vegetarian because the Seventh-day Adventists are vegetarian. And I said, how about steaklets? Steaklets is a very delicious meat analog. And I told her about them, and she says, I only have $250 to spend on it. And I said, well, if it goes over, I can incur that without detriment. And she says, well, the pastor won't let you. The pastor will pay it. And I says, no, you ask the pastor if I can pay it. So I went to my friends at the Seventh-day Adventist Church in Schenectady, which is really Gilderland, and I asked them what they had in their store. They, you know, Seventh-day Adventist churches always used to have a health food store in the back of the church. And I asked them what they had. And I found a steakless to feed 30 people, and then we'll go into scallops to feed 30 more, and vegetarian steaks to feed 30 more, and so forth. So I got up enough food to feed 204 people, and Donna says that it would be 150 people is what she would buy for. And the cost of it for the meat analogs, the green beans, the mashed potato and the gravy, the cost of it is something like $363. So the Adventist could pay $250 and I could pay $113. So it could be delivered on March the 22nd. I've got it all set up. I've got to call Donna and ask her if she approves of it.
Well, that's quite a bit to feed.
Yes, but they do it fine.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It's always Tuesday night when you're feeding your kids.
Yeah, and on Monday night, the 21st, I'm taking, I have two friends and my youngest daughter. We've been doing this for 50 years. And we've taken one out for a birthday.
Who? Sure.
We've taken Donna, one of the four, out for her birthday. And we're going to the Thai place on the 21st.
Oh, yeah. Why don't you go to Ginny's Kitchen? I've heard that's a very good restaurant.
Go to where?
Ginny's Kitchen.
The Ginny's Kitchen. Nah, they like to go out, so...
Oh, okay.
We'll go out, you know.
Okay. So what did you think?
We let the person that has a birthday pick where they want to go.
Okay. What did you think of the long tale I just told you?
About the food?
About the dinners at the Lutheran church.
Yeah. Well, they sound nice.
Okay.
You know, I just don't eat all of that.
Yeah, I know that. And I don't either. But you've got, this is the entree for people to get away from killing animals.
Yeah, but the Seventh-day Adventists eat it all the time, don't they?
No, they don't, really. They eat a lot of rice. They eat, like, your beans and rice.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I'd love to have you make that for me to take to the Seventh Day, your beans and greens. They never had that. Anyway, they eat a lot of rice.
Yeah.
And they eat a lot of vegetable dishes, like they had spinach balls last Saturday that were very good.
Yeah, because I don't like eating
that fake stuff. No, I don't either. But I'm way beyond that. In fact, I don't even eat what you eat. I really eat what they call agape, which is fruit, nuts, raw vegetables, and I eat hot cereal. But really, I eat raw.
Yeah. Well, I eat a lot of fruit raw, but I like.
And you eat a lot of salads too.
Do you eat grits anymore? Have you cooked any more grits?
Yeah, grits are great.
Yeah.
I don't eat until noon, Ginny. I fast until noon.
Yeah. I used to fast one day a week.
Wow.
I did that for years. I fast one day a week.
Yeah.
But I seem to have low sugar or something. If I don't eat something every now and then, I get shaky.
Yeah, you will. Yeah, I tried it for two and a half days.
I don't fast anymore, but I used to fast one day a week.
Yes, that's good. Yeah.
Yeah, for years I fasted one day a week.
Good. Okie doke, Ginny.
Well, you have a blessed day.
Yes, and I thank you for blessing it, hon.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Does changing from daylight to... saving time, or for changing from standard time to daylight saving time, does that mix you all up? That mixes up my body. How do you solve that, folks? How do you solve that? That was a long conversation, so we'd better recharge the phone. So I keep two clocks. My watch is on body time, and my and then people time is on this great big clock here. Well, you know what I wanted to do with you? I thought in the middle of the night. I wanted to do this with you. Can you go 5 seconds without thinking about yourself? Let's try it. Close the eyes. 5 seconds without thinking about yourself. Open your eyes. Did you make it? Did you make it without thinking about your grocery list or your housework or your job or something else? Let's try 10 seconds. This is God time, by the way. on the 15th of March. I told you that. Okay. 10 seconds without thinking of yourself. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That was 10 seconds. Can you go 15? I don't think so. You just started. You probably can't do it at all. What's nice about that? No ego. What's nice about that? It rests the brain. Gives the brain a rest. What else is nice about it? I don't think any thoughts will come to you from allness, wholeness, oneness, the universe, God. I don't think that will happen because you turned off all the receptors. Can you do it for 15? Let's go. I didn't make it. I was thinking that in television, if the operator of the cable casting hears silence for 15 seconds, he's going to run and turn it off, thinking that the program is over or something's wrong with it. I almost made it, though. But you can do that so that you'll do it 15 seconds at a time. You'll get that. Then you can do the next 15 seconds, which is a half a minute, and then the next 15, which is three quarter, and the next one is a whole minute. And then you can do it 2 minutes at a time, and that's equivalent to 40 count blessings and rejoices every hour. And something else came to me middle of the night last night to tell you. What was it? I don't know, but something that comes to me right now is praying for people. No. Take Joanne. I really can't pray for Joanne, say to God, make her healthy. Why? Because God knows that, and God wants her to be healthy. So the praying is sort of addressing Joanne and saying, Joanne, what can we do to give you the strength and the discipline and the routine to make the connection with the oneness and allness and greatness of the universe and get away from your ego? Get away from taking everything you can out of life and bringing it towards yourself for your benefit. Instead, take everything out of you and push it into life for other people's benefit. How do I pray to that person to do that? And that's the way to health. That's the way to health. Continually over the years, that kind of attitude is the way to health. No ego, selflessness, everything for others. That's God time this morning. And we do have a hymn. What is it? Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of all creation. Praise Him, my soul, for He is thy health and salvation. All ye who hear, to His temple draw near. Join us in glad adoration. Hey, join us in glad adoration. Join us in glad adoration. Boy, that'll fix us up. Join us in glad adoration. Good morning, everybody. It's in the vicinity of 9:15, 9:30, the day before St. Patrick's Day. St. Patrick's Week. Let us call Ginny Palmer and hear what Sarah Young has for us. And how are you? And it's sunny, and it looks like it's in the 40s. And this is the last day of winter. And last night, folks, I saw something that illustrated perfectly our hypothesis that life is all about working together for the good of all, and not taking life for ourselves, not taking life for ego, for selfishness. 250 people gathered up from all over the neighborhood, went to see a film on climate control. The erosion of our earth through carbon dioxide.
Hello?
Hey, Ginny, how are you this morning?
I'm okay, how are you?
Oh, 100%, thank you. Yes, do you know what the temperature is?
I didn't hear you.
Temperature?
No, I don't. But I'm going to go out and rake. I'm loose on all my flowers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Any blossoms yet?
I haven't even been out the last couple of days. Yesterday, I moved kindling. I had kindling that was under my porch.
Yes.
And I moved it out because I won't be needing it. And I brought out some of my porch furniture. And so I didn't get into the flower beds yesterday, but I'm going today.
That's an advance. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So it's a beautiful day to do it. I think tomorrow's supposed to be all right now. The weekend's supposed to go downhill a little, I think.
We shall see, and we shall stay in the present, and we'll enjoy every moment of this sunshine. How's that?
Oh, yeah. I'm an outdoor person, you know. I love the outdoors. That's why I spend so much time on my porch when it's warmer. I eat all my meals out there and everything. Okay, today's the 16th. I just read this a few minutes ago. It is good that you recognize your weakness. That keeps you looking at me, your strength. Abundant life is not necessary health and wealth. It is living in continuous dependence on me instead of trying to fit this day into a preconceived mold. Relax and be on the lookout for what I'm doing. The mind set will free you to enjoy me and find out what I plan for you to do.
I'll go with that.
This is far better than any trying to make things go according to your own plans.
Right.
And don't take yourself so seriously. Lighten up and laugh with me.
Good.
You have me on your side, so what are you worried about?
Good.
I will equip you to do absolutely anything as long as it is in my will.
What? What?
He said, I will equip you to do almost anything as long as it's in my will.
Okay.
He'll help us do anything but what's in his will for us to do.
Yeah, and he and God will do the equipping?
Yeah, as long as it's in his will.
Good.
Yeah. The most difficult day, the more I yearn to help you.
Wait a second. That's a good thing to remember. God will do the equipping as long as it's in his will, and we don't have to struggle to do the equipping.
Yeah. Anxiety wraps you up in yourself, trapping you in your own thoughts.
What?
You look
What was that?
Anxiety. Oh.
Yeah.
In yourself. And in you and your own thoughts.
Anxiety and ego. Ego.
Yeah. When you look to me and whisper my name, you break free and receive my help.
Yeah.
Focus on me and you will find peace in my presence.
Yes. Now, wait a second. There's something there. It's to receive my help. Well, I would say that that we wouldn't live to do our projects so that we wouldn't need help. We're living to do God's projects, and then God will equip us to do that.
Yeah, He will equip us to do it. What's in His will?
That's right. And
he didn't
I don't
say He would equip us to do what's in our will.
Yeah.
It's in His will.
There's a very fine thought there, and it's that it's the help. We don't need help because that means that we were helping ourselves. What we just need is to do God's help, and God will equip us to do that. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yes, definitely.
So I said to him, you know, I need your wisdom to do it right. I don't need to go out there and not think about something and pull something out and have it follow me, you know?
Yeah. I would add to that that you're not doing your work, you're doing God's work. It's not your work, it's God's work.
Yeah, well, it tells you that any job you do it as unto the Lord. When I try to keep my property up, I'm doing it because I need to set an example that I'm not lazy and I'm thankful for what God's given me.
Yes, but there again, Jenny, it is not your property; it is God's property.
I know that. Yeah, I know that.
He's given me
to live here, and that's why. I said to him, you know, I don't do this just because I don't have anything to do. I said, I do this because this place represents God.
That's
it
right.
It shouldn't be run down and looking.
That's right.
Look nice.
That's right.
And I said, when we used to rent it to the chiropractor, they used to keep that window so pretty. The woman that worked for him decorated it all the time. It was so nice. And when I started doing this, and then I go over and look at the Gathering Place, and everything was thrown in there, and it looked crappy. And I said, we're supposed to represent God. It shouldn't look like that. So I started doing it, you know? So I said to Pastor, you know, I don't do this just because I don't have anything else to do. I do this because we're supposed to be good stewards on what God's given us.
That's right.
So I said, that's why I do this. I come down here. This place represents God. So it should look nice, like it's cared for. And that's the way I feel about my property. It should look like it's cared for because this is God's property.
That's my point.
Yep. That's why I try to keep my, you know, the best I can.
Yeah.
I try to keep it up. I try to paint it and make it look nice. Because a lot of God's people, what does the Bible say? Don't be slothful. That means, you know, take care of things. So, that's what I try to do. Okay, he gave us two scriptures here. I have strength for all things in Christ who empowers me. I am ready for anything and able to anything through Him who infuses inner strength unto me. I am so
Excellent.
Yeah. That tells you right there.
Yep.
And a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones.
What?
A cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. So, you know, these people that walk around like they're eating sour grapes, you know, nothing's right for them. And, you know, it does a number on you when you think like that.
I know it. So what are we going to do to help them?
Well, I don't know.
There you do.
Prayer, and, you know, be cheerful yourself, too. Don't add to it, you know? Sometimes, you know, God's working on changing them. And she's having to rob you. We have one lady that's been coming into the other place for years. She got the worst attitude that you've ever seen a woman have. She, her husband left her, she's just mean spirit. You can just tell that. So, you know the one that made you the quilt? Artist?
Oh yes, artist.
Artist made her a blanket. And gave it to her.
Nice.
And she was so happy that somebody thought enough of her to do something like that for her, that her spirit changed.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And you know what Pastor tells us? If you got somebody that acts like they don't like you, buy them a cup of coffee. Give them a flower. Do something nice for them.
Good. And so this woman, did she continue with a cheerful heart?
Well, she's not 100%, but she's changed. She's so much different.
Well, really? And have you done anything for her lately?
Well, she comes to the Gallon Place all the time, and we're always nice and cheerful to her, but she saves coupons for us, because a lot of people save coupons to save on groceries, you know?
Yes.
So she comes in every day and tries to do something back for us. She gives us coupons.
Oh, that's a nice story. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's God working. You know, somebody already thought enough of her to make her quilt.
Yeah.
And she felt she's not all alone in this world. People that care about her.
She's got a quilt, yeah.
Yeah, and she can come in and talk to us about anything. And we're always nice to her. Even when she wasn't nice, we were nice to her.
Oh.
And she was not nice because she was hurting.
Yeah.
See, she was hurting. And
yeah.
She didn't know what to do with the hurt. So it's a lot of hurting people out there. And we help a lot of people. You wouldn't believe how many people that comes in there is trying to get somewhere and don't even have gas in their car. We don't give them money, but we'll take them and buy them gas.
You yeah. What? What do you do?
We take them and buy them gas.
How do you do that? You go to
You go with them to the gas station and pay for it.
Hey, nice.
Because if you give them money and you don't know what they do with it, because...
Yeah, it might be for an addiction.
So we don't give out money. But if somebody comes through and definitely don't have a place to stay, it's lots of times we rent them a room.
Rent them a room?
Yeah. Spend the night.
You have a room down there to spend the night?
No, we don't. We take them to a motel and spend it in room of a room.
Oh.
It's been added. I've seen that done lots of times.
How much does that cost to rent a motel room?
I have no idea. Pastor, that's why we take up alms. So we got money for things like that.
Oh, yeah.
And we've had people come through the travel and don't have a bit of food. We pack them up all kinds of food that they can eat in the car. You know,
that's good.
Not long ago, this woman that lived not no food in her house, and she didn't even have no dog food. Diane packed up food, dog food, everything, went to her house, brought it to her. See, we do a lot of stuff behind the scenes that nobody knows is going on.
How far away was she?
Just a few miles.
Wasn't that nice? Boy, that must give you a good feeling to do that.
Well, that's why I'm so about our church. We do a lot of things that people don't even know about it.
You still go over to Troy to the homeless people?
No, we don't have enough people to work that anymore. And somebody stole part off our van, too.
What? They stole a part off of your van?
Yeah. It's something on things that sells for good money, and they junk it, you know?
Oh, and now the van is inoperative?
Well, I think they got it running now. I don't know, but it wasn't for a while.
Oh.
So, anyway.
Oh, it was probably some cocaine addict.
Yeah, they, you know, when they take that stuff, they lose all.
Oh, they lose them. That's all their whole life is cocaine.
Yeah, they lose all sense of right and wrong, too.
Oh, well, sure they do. All they want is that euphoria.
Yeah, they just want that, you know. It's a guy that I've been praying for years. It used to be a friend of John's. And he's so hooked on crack.
What's crack? Is crack cocaine?
No, that's something different.
Oh.
Crack is a man-made something, I would rather. I don't know what it is, but it really, when you get hooked on it, it's like the other stuff. You've got to have it, you know?
Yeah, and that's all life is.
Yeah, and he went through being a big strapping man, and you ought to see him. He looks like a skeleton. He came in one day down together place, crying. And told me that his mother had died, and she lived out of town, and he didn't have the money to go pay his final respects for him.
Do you believe it?
So I gave him $100.
Do you believe it, honey?
No, well, let me finish the story. So I told John about it. John said, Mama, his mother died about a month ago. He took that money and went for crap.
Oh, and bless your heart. Oh.
John went after it.
He did?
You gotta pay my mama back that money. You come and cut wood for me, and I'll pay you until mama's money is paid back. You're not going to take advantage of her like that. So John made him pay me back.
Oh, he did?
Because I did it. I did it out of a good heart. I looked at this man, and I thought, well, if that was my son, I'd want somebody to help him. So I'll help it, you know.
And yeah. It would have been good to apply your policy. Well, we won't give you the money, but we'll take you there. Where is it?
Well, I couldn't do that. I can't just.
No, you can't do that. But you could have asked somebody to help you do that.
Well,
and
not
so did
anybody that can just take off and go.
And so did.
Night, you know?
And so did John. Did John give him any money?
Oh, John wouldn't give him a cent.
I see.
But John made him work off his money and paid me back. Because he was John's friend.
Yeah, I understand.
So he came to me. He figured I'm a soft touch, which I am. But pastors always told us, don't give anybody any money. Help them, but don't give them no money.
Yeah, you're right about that. And I have made that mistake many times. And from henceforth, I will not do it.
And, Pastor always told us when we went to work with the homeless, there's two things you can't do. You can't give them money, and you can't take them home. So, at one time down there, it was a nice young man. He was, didn't have a home. And you know how I feel about young people, young kids and stuff. And Pastor said, you can't take anybody home with you. Because you don't know what they do when you take them home. You know?
Yeah, I made that mistake too.
Yeah, well, Pastor told us that, and we'll do anything we can down to gather help to help a person when they need. But we're not going to give them money. So, we do anything else. So,
Yeah.
But we found that out. So anybody that needs a plane, the pastor takes them out and runs them a room. He takes them to fill their car with gas. We give them food. We've had people come in there in the winter and not have a coat. Not even have a coat.
Sad.
Yes, it is. But you know, all this stuff is self-inflicted.
Yeah.
It's self-inflicted.
Yes.
You can't just believe everything everybody tells you.
Right.
Yeah, you know. But a lot of help goes out of that gathering place.
I'm listening to a lecture on DVDs that I get from the library, and the lecture is on willpower. What do you think about willpower?
What do you mean? Your will to do something?
Yeah, willpower.
Well, I think that when people set their mind to do something, they usually can do it.
Uh-huh.
But when you're determined to do something, that's how this country was built, because these people were strong people and was determined I read a lot of books on how this, you know, people, these settlers, they came with nothing, built their houses out of sod or out of wood, you know.
Yeah.
Logs.
Yeah, well,
and they were mindset that they were going to survive.
That's right. My ancestors came 20 years after the Pilgrims.
Yeah,
but they also ruined the country. They took down the trees and they took the animals for fur, and they did a lot of harm. You don't need meat.
Well, back then, you know, you ate whatever you could get to desire to live on. And people didn't, you know, when I became a vegetarian, nobody had ever heard of that before.
Yeah.
It was unheard of. You're going back now 61 years.
Yeah.
Almost 62 years.
Yeah.
Nobody ever heard the word vegetarian.
No.
I didn't know the word myself. All I said is I'm not going to eat meat.
Sure.
And nobody knew anything about that. When they got something to eat that tasted good, they were very thankful for it.
Well, I'm glad you did, and you were right.
Well, the Indians always thought that these animals would lay down their life for you. They gave you so you could live. That's the way they thought about it, and that's the way, like the Eskimos and all, they, when they killed something, they thought about that this person had given their spirit so I can live.
Bad, very bad.
Well, how do you get out the Bible with all the fish and stuff?
You go to Genesis 1:29, you shall eat green fruit.
It said you'd be healthier if you ate it.
Well, of course you are. And that you're unhealthy because...
about Jesus and cooking fish on the thing and eating it. And when he needed money, he told the disciples to go catch a fish and look in his mouth and get the money piece out and pay the taxes.
Does that fit in with Genesis 1:29? You shall eat
bread. Let me look it up. Wait a minute. I'll look it up right now. I got my Bible right here. Look at the animals that were sacrificed.
Do you want kindness or do you want cruelty? Now it's your decision. But you can help them see the light.
And God said, behold, I have given you every herb, bearing seed, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree in which yields, which is the fruit of the tree, yield and seed. This is talking about, to you it should be me. It's talking about that, and he said, and to every beast on the earth, and to every fowl of the air, and to everything that creeps upon the earth, I have given every green herb for meat, and it is so. Now, the way I understand it, they didn't eat meat until after the flood.
Well, it's an easy
choice.
It's an easy choice. Do you want to take somebody's life, or do you don't want to?
Well, I know that. I made that decision, so you don't have to argue with me, but I can't argue with everybody else. Yeah, you know, even now, a lot of the places are starting where they won't use the eggs, and if the chicken is free, and that's a release.
But wait a second. That's not the issue. The issue is that the hen is trying to have a family. Is it right to take her eggs?
Every egg a chicken takes, if you hatched every egg that the chicken lays, you couldn't take it the country would be overrun with it.
That's up to God. That's not up to us.
Oh, well, I don't see any reason at all not to.
I don't see why you argue those things. You know that's not right.
I don't see anything wrong with the eggs, and I don't see why
you're going to take
a. We don't have to kill anything to get it, and we don't have to kill a cow to get its milk. And I don't see anything wrong with that.
Do you? You don't see anything wrong with robbing an animal? And why do you stick up for it?
I believe that it's okay. I don't kill anything. I draw the line at killing. I do not draw the line at taking an egg if you need something to eat. I don't draw the line at taking milk.
Why do you steal a hen's egg? Why do people?
You know, he gave when he put them in the garden. He gave them over all the animals.
He gave his stewardship, not exploitation.
I'm not going to argue with you, Vendora. I don't see anything wrong with the milk and the eggs. I see something wrong with the killing. The other stuff, I think it's just people have decided that that's not right and they do it. But
God gave the milk to a calf, not to people.
The calf does not drink milk but maybe 6 months of its life.
No, that's not right.
The milk the rest of the time.
No, that's man intervening. No, that's man intervening. God gave that milk to a baby cow. And just as God gives.
I'm arguing with you, Vendora. I think that's wrong. And I have a right for my own choice.
Yeah,
I can draw the line with killing. I do not draw the line with milk. I do not draw the line with eggs. And I'm not going to change my mind.
Okay, you also have a duty to listen to me and other people.
Well, I listen to you, but I don't agree with you. So I have a right not to agree with you. I think this, and adding all of that man-made chemicals to make all of that food that you eat is totally wrong.
You also have a conscience.
You know what? When you put stuff in your body that's not natural, it stores it, and that's what causes cancer.
Yes, and eggs are a culture for cancer, and so is milk.
I don't eat eggs, and I don't drink milk.
I'm not talking.
I don't think it's wrong.
Okay, if you're going to get hot-headed, there's no point in going on.
No, it isn't. So you have a good day.
Yes, and thank you for blessing it. Isn't that interesting? Isn't that interesting? The thing is to do, not to say anything. The thing to do is to send pulses of understanding and compassion and love. And do unto others as you would have them do unto you. I'm sorry. I lost my self-possession. I am sorry. I was wrong. I face it. I will go out and make good. I am sorry. Now, I guess that takes care of God time. Anyway, this lecture I'm listening to by a professor from Princeton University. Neuroscience, and they're all wrong. taking an animal's life and torturing it and taking parts of the brain and putting in other parts of the brain in mice and rats. That's wrong, entirely wrong. And every time they tell about the information they got from doing that, I fast forward it. I penalize them. I fast forward it. I won't listen to it. When they talk about experiments on humans, though, in the psychology lab that don't hurt anybody, but do give information, that's innocuous. But his subject right now is willpower. Ginny knows she's wrong. That's why she gets so angry. She knows that she's wrong. And that's why she, and then she also knows that she's wrong and that she ran away. I think Ginny should just listen. That's what I should have done. Just listen. Anyway, about willpower. What do you think about willpower? What's on your mind from making up willpower? What do you want to use your willpower on right now? New Year's resolutions. Did you have any? I had 4. And I'm not doing well. I did well the month of January and half of February, but I've fallen down. Help me. Saintly eating. And by that I mean salad. Green lettuce, green cucumber, green pepper, and green avocado. Fresh fruit. Orange, apples, bananas, grapes. Hot cereal. Right now it's cream of wheat, and I think it should be better with Maltex or maple or what's that other one? Malto meal. 4. Peanut butter and crackers. 12 grain bread. 5. Nut fruit shake. Oats, pineapple juice, banana, and cashews. Great shake. And granola. That's what the regimen of saintly eating is. Do you have any New Year's resolutions? And how are you doing? I've given you one breakfast. You ready for another one? Okay, can you wait just a second, please? You can't. All right, gotta go, folks. The third one was, when you get angry, shut up. When you get angry, silent. And that's what I should have done with Ginny. She's the only vegetarian I know. No, that's not so. But she's one of the very few. The argument about vegetarian, do you want to be cruel or do you want to be kind? You want to be kind or you want to be unkind? Do you want to be selfish or you want to be giving? What's the fourth thing? Eat right. I don't want to think of them. Eat right. About anger. Oh yeah, be refined. Be refined. It's nice to see somebody with good manners and refined. Keep your hands away from your face. Unless you're in the bathroom. Keep your hands away from your face. And what's the fourth one? That's great. New Year's resolutions, and I can't even remember the fourth one. I'm chagrined. So that's What is the fourth New Year's resolution? Anyway, willpower is a very challenging thing to work on. It's fun. The success is euphoric. The failure is dismal. And I guess this is why I can't think of it. I've got my mind on feeding this kitty cat. Want me to read you the menu? You can have vegan franks, you can have steaklets. Let's go for the vegan franks. You seem to go for those this morning. It seems I just fed you a little while ago, didn't I? Oh no, that was at 6 o'clock. To God be the glory, great things he hath done. So loved he the world, he gave us his son, who offered his life an atonement for sin, and opened the life gate that all may come in. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory, great things he hath done. .com, kitty cat, look at us. Look at us, .com. Look over here, .com, where the vegan franks are. Look over here, honey. You just feed me, that's all. Just feed me.
Protecting us. And they're cheap. They're cheap for a police force. Why were so against them? I don't understand that.
That's true. The thing I have against them is that they caused the village $2 or $3 million in a lawsuit for taking away a boy's life and making a young lady crippled for the rest of her life. And
what
then, what's that? Well, that was about 3 years ago, and the lawsuit was just settled. It was in a chase. They were chasing a car, and they ran into her. She was coming out of the village. Actually, it happened up at Schoolhouse Road.
Yes.
You don't remember that case?
No.
And then recently they were in another chase and they cost the police $40,000 in a new vehicle. But then to counter that was Gaetano's hour long, 45 minutes. He made a 45 minute speech and he went through the resumes of all the police officers. And they all had great records. They were heroes. That was to counteract that.
Yeah, I think people make mistakes. That sounds like it might have been one.
Say that again.
I think that, people do make mistakes, obviously.
Yeah. Well, that's very... Very, that's disheartening to you. One vote?
One vote.
Who ever thought it would be that close in our village? I think Gaetano won the village board by one vote, too. Against,
oh my goodness.
Against, who was it? Was it against John Warner? Or was it against... against somebody, and they show, and that person who lost shows up at the village board and complains to get even.
Yeah.
Well, that is something in our little village, and you're upset. What can I do to make you feel better?
I just... Nothing. I really hope that it'll be okay. I'm sure it will. And love will win, I think. Love will always win.
What? Who always wins?
Love.
Love always wins.
Love will win.
Oh, yep. that's good to hear. Thank you. That's very good. Well, what will I do with my friend Kurt? You know, I call him maybe 2-3 times a week, and we go out together every now and then to Stewart's. We go and support the local. Oh, here is something. All right, did you want to say anything more about that before I tell you something new? Yes. Well, you should. You should indeed, and I'm always ready to listen. I wanted to tell you this, that Madeline was at the mobile station putting something into those nice people who do the good by taking the clothes and the shoes, and then they go out and try to help people all over the world in peace. A man came up in a car, and she said to him, "Are you the new owner?" And he said, "Yes." And she said, "What are you going to do with it?" He says, I'm going to have a gas station and a subway shop.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow. That would be good.
Well, honey, we don't really need it.
No, but wouldn't it be better than nothing?
Well, that's true. However, I was hoping it would be put to better use.
Me too.
And of course, Smith's hardware store next to it is a mess.
His
U-Haul and his unpainted business, his unpainted building. And then that whole strip starting with the pale green house on Route 203 coming right into the head of the village. All of those should be torn down and turned into senior housing.
I agree.
But the village it just doesn't have the money.
No.
Now you walk, you know, you drive into Kinderhook. You've been into Kinderhook. You know, every square foot is perfect. Mm-hmm. But they have the money.
Yeah.
And they're very anti-business. If a house comes up for sale, or if a building comes up for sale, if it's been a business, let's put it this way, if it has been a business and it comes up for sale, they have an ordinance that it has to be turned into a home.
Wow.
It's not a happy, convenient place to live. Nassau is. You can go to Stewart, you can go to Cumberland, you can go to Sunoco, you can go to the hardware store, you can go to the computer store.
Right.
You can go to the gift.
I feel like we need to be, I think if you're pro-business, we need to be willing to pay taxes to support pedestrians in the village.
To support what?
Pedestrians.
Oh, yes.
You know, make it a walkable community.
That's right, and there's hardly any pedestrians. No, no. And that's what undid my friend's antique shop. There was no ambience, and there was no parking place, and so she couldn't sustain it.
Yeah.
And people don't walk to church, they drive to church. They don't walk to the library, they drive to the library. Mm-hmm. Oh, you should have seen the crowd last night at the St. Mary's Fellowship Hall. This man came into town named Josh Fox, and he's put made a film of climate change.
Oh, I wanted to go to that so bad, but I had Lego Club.
Yeah.
How was that?
Yeah. Well, it was packed. It was packed. We had to park way, speaking of no walking, parking, we had to park way down Phillips Street, way down, whatchamacallit, Tremont Street. It was so packed. That parking lot was full, and there must have been 250 people.
Wow, that's wonderful.
And he talked about climate change all over the world.
Well,
and he talked about, Hurricane Sandy, and they pointed out to the audience that they shouldn't have called it a hurricane, and instead they should have called it a Hurricane Exelon. And these are the people who are causing it.
Wow.
And it was really forceful, and they called up Governor Cuomo with his cell phone and had us all say, a vote against the pipeline. It was all through the pipeline people. It was all through the pipeline people. And this Josh is going, he's mapped out 100 towns across the USA, and he's done 10 of them already.
Wow.
And so he came to us because we're against the pipeline. And I believe that both Gildebrand and Schumer have taken the next step against the pipeline.
Oh, good.
And now I think it's waiting on Cuomo, so they're working on Cuomo. And we had made big signs to say that we were against it, and we stood up and made a video of it against it.
Mm.
And Dave Fleming was there. Dave Fleming is on crutches. What happened to him?
I don't know.
Yeah, he's on crutches.
Mm.
He does.
Yeah.
Well, they did a very bad thing. They cut down a spruce tree out there in that lawn, and that building looks so barren. Right across from the library, they cut down that beautiful spruce tree.
Oh, my goodness.
And it looks so bare.
Why did they do that?
Oh, it was awful. It made the building picturesque. Yeah, and we need shade on the commons.
Yes.
It's awfully hot there. You have to go practically down to the New Hope Church to get any shade.
Yes. I don't understand that.
Yeah.
What
will we do?
The climate change is Trump. Trump.
Oh, really? Yes, the others have been pretty. Yeah, the others have been pretty silent on it, haven't they?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He's the only one, and he's not going
to
win.
No.
So.
Well, that's why I get so disenchanted with voting, because all of them are paid by big industry. All of them are paid by the international bankers. The international bankers give money to all of them, and when they get into the White House, they don't have a say. They do what the international bankers tell them to do.
Mm-hmm.
It goes very broadly and very, very deeply. It's the international bankers.
Mm-hmm.
And the international bankers took away our interest and got away with it. Nobody fought it. When you were a little girl and your mother and father, you used to get 6% interest on your savings.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Now you don't get anything.
No.
In three years, I have got a dollar's interest. 3 years.
Wow.
Well, listen, we know what to do, and that's what, how you live your life, with kindness and helpfulness and goodness and belief and in just being nice. So that's what it comes down to.
That's right.
That's really our goal. It's just goodness and kindness and helpfulness.
Love will always win.
Yeah, I'm sorry that the bad guys won. I'm sorry, but we just got to go on. But our day will come.
Yeah.
Our day will come.
Mm-hmm. Can't give up, right?
No, oh no! No, you just go on being yourself and doing all the good things that you do all day long with a load that you have and bringing up a lovely family. How is the little boy?
Oh, he's wonderful.
Is he walk?
Oh,
is
but Dora, he walked.
Oh, now
he
you're in.
The other day.
He did?
Yes.
How, tell me about it. Where did he walk to and from?
Well, I was in the kitchen and I turned around and he was kind of on his own in the middle of the kitchen, standing up.
Wow.
and he walked to me, and then, of course, they were so excited, and they gave him a big group hug. It was really cute.
How many steps?
Oh, he probably did about 6 or 7.
Now, isn't that wonderful how quickly that came and how suddenly?
I know.
Isn't God great with his putting 2 cells together and making all those other cells and then making all this motion? Isn't that great?
Mm, yes. And what was great about it, I just loved the reaction from you and Aunt Fiona. They were just so happy for him.
Isn't that so cute? Now,
yes, it melted my heart.
Fiona is 8. No, I mean, Ewan is 8.
Ewan is 9 now.
4th grade, almost.
Almost.
And then, the other one is...
Fiona's
6. She's 6 now?
Yeah.
1st grade, almost.
Almost, yeah.
Well, you've done a wonderful job, you and your husband. I'm listening to one of your lectures from, by the way, I have about 10 DVDs that I have watched from your library, and I thank you for that. And I have about 10 more. I've just about through my list of science and mathematics.
So those are good courses, huh, Glendora?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I wish you and your family had it. Time to watch them. Here it is, the best. This one is I'm watching this morning. It's Princeton University, and it's on neuroscience. And the upside is that he's talking about willpower now. Willpower and the brain.
Oh.
And that's very, very interesting. How willpower is finite. It's finite. The brain doesn't have an infinite sources of willpower. So that's very interesting. But when they start talking about taking cells out of the brain of a rat, then I punish them by fast forwarding. I will not listen to it.
Yeah.
That's the downside. But the other side is when they have experiments in the psychology lab with people and it's about behavior, and you know, that doesn't do anybody any harm. So he had quite a few experiments on willpower. So anyway, so think of it. Princeton University, the University of California at Berkeley, Vanderbilt, all these great professors, all these great people who have devoted their lives to finding these things out. And I am going to write to both of the neuroscience people, a woman named Dr. Norden and this man named Sam Wong. I'm going to write to them and tell them that the end does not justify the means. You just don't do that to little animals.
Yeah.
You don't come in as a bully and capture them and confine them and cut them up and throw them away. You just don't do that.
Yeah.
You just don't do that. What's wrong that they can't see that? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to write them both letters and congratulate them on their love of nature and trying to understand nature, which is really God. And I'm just going to tell them, you don't do that.
Yeah.
But anyway, the point I'm trying to make with you is that I thank you for these great courses.
Oh, good. Good, good.
Yeah. Can I do anything for you?
No. No, I'm good. We're doing wonderful. It's a beautiful day.
Okay, honey, let me know if I can, and we've really got to get together, although this has been very nice.
Yes, next time.
Now I've got to call Kurt, you know, because I call him, as I say, 2-3 times a week.
Yeah, so you can tell him, you heard it through the newspaper.
Yes, okay.
I mean, he must have heard by now, don't you think?
Oh, sure. He heard he was probably there when it came in, when they counted him last night.
Yeah.
Oh, and he made an agreement with Lori Clark that if he ran, Lori wouldn't. So that was pretty nice.
Yeah.
And he also asked Margaret. And Margaret was okay with it.
Yes, he's just very respectful.
It's a wonderful thing. You know, a very interesting thing about him is that he didn't do all of these things that he wanted to do. You know, be on the library board and, run for office. He didn't do these all the time his mother was alive. He just stayed home with her and took care of her. And everywhere he...
Yes, that's what you told me, yeah.
Well, you know that. You saw his behavior. Everywhere he went, he took his mother. And he didn't do all these things that he wanted to do.
Right. He was just devoted.
And he just stayed home and took care of her, because I heard him say to her one time, I know you don't want to be alone, but it'll only take me a minute to take Glendora home.
Aww.
And he says, I know you don't want to be alone, because she would want to go with him. But he explained to her that it would only be a minute, and it was only a minute or two. Well, things are happening around about that big attendance last night and that big rally.
Mm-hmm.
For the pipeline.
Yep.
I got a joke to tell you.
Okay.
This Baptist minister would go see his flock every Wednesday. And he said, Farmer Brown, it's been a long, long time since you have been to church. And Farmer Brown says, well, all I got is this farming gear. I can't wear that to church. And the next Wednesday, the Baptist minister brought Farmer Brown a lovely suit of clothing. But come Sunday, Farmer Brown was still not in church. And the Baptist minister said, Farmer Brown, I'm astounded that you were not in church Sunday. And Farmer Brown says, those clothes you gave me were so nice, I thought I could go to the Episcopal Church. Thank you for your call. And
oh, well, I'm glad you're doing well. 98%. That is pretty good. Hopefully the other 2% will get better.
Okay, it's better right now. I am 100%. One thing that kept me from you, of course, was the fact of doing 300 duplications of the TV show to 61 TV stations.
Oh, my goodness.
And you know, that takes quite a lot of time. So that's one reason I haven't been in touch. All right, but we'll get together soon.
Okay.
Goodbye. Bye. Goodbye, my neighbor and friend.
All right. Goodbye.
Now, how do I tell Kurt? I know it's numbered by heart. That's one I haven't forgotten. By the way, I found out what that fourth New Year's resolution was. Write nicely. Write legibly. Now, how could I forget that? How could you forget a New Year's resolution on the day before St. Patrick's Day? Okay, I don't know what to say to him. Is it true? It's Glendora, Kurt. Is it true? Is it true? Did it happen? I am so... Well, I don't know what I am. But I certainly feel it deeply. Almost as deeply as you. But I know there's something more coming. If it is true, something better is coming. Something better is coming. And we love you all the more. The outpouring of love is all the more for you and for all that you've done. For all that you've done for this village, for all that you've done for your mom. We're on your side. We're with you, Kurt. And the good should have won. The good should have won, Kurt. But I'll say this, that the last word has not been said, and the last word has not been spoken. And when it will be spoken by God. And you are a winner. You are a winner. I'm sorry, Kurt. And I bet Tuxedo is very upset too. I bet she's as upset as I am. God be with you until we talk again. I'm glad that the recorder was on. Made it easier. There's good in it. I can see good in it now, and there will be more good coming.
It went great.
Oh, I met a vegetarian the other day.
Did you?
Yeah.
How could you tell?
They had a sign.
I have a way of knowing.
Tell us about it, Joyce.
Well, she works, so I said I'd let her know, or she should let me know when she can come.
Yeah.
She's a real vegetarian.
She is?
Yeah.
Like what?
Well, oh, she's not vegan, but she's a real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where'd you meet her, dear?
On a hike. She was a friend of a friend's.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I think it's wonderful the way you hike.
As long as I can. And then I'm telling people that are eating meat why they shouldn't eat meat.
Good for you.
And why they should adopt dogs and not buy dogs. And it's like...
Good for you. Oh, you're a real good person.
I try.
Where do you go on your hike, dear?
All over. I've been every... You know, we pick a different place each time. So I never know. You're all set for tomorrow, and so am I.
Wow, what is that?
I don't know.
You handsome waiter.
Oh, hi. Hello. We have more people.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Glendora.
How nice you came.
I'm Gary.
I think we met.
Did we?
And you know Joyce?
I'm Joyce.
Hi, Joyce.
Are you from Nassau?
I'm Marlene, and I'm from Postenkill.
Oh, wow, you came a distance? Yeah.
Won't you come in and sit down?
No. 6 minutes.
Oh, not that much. Maddie, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Your name was?
Marlene.
Marlene.
All right. So is this the dishes and stuff?
No. Probably.
Come and sit with me.
It's starting to rain.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
Are there reserved seats?
So what'd you do? Anywhere you like.
Excuse me?
What'd you do all day?
Oh, God. I took the cat to the vet.
Oh, okay. You want to go there first? Want to go to the table first?
Yes.
How nice you brought us something. Thank you.
I brought black bean soup.
You like them, Joyce? You like our plate?
Yeah, they're nice.
A brand spanking new. Better wash them. Hey, Joyce.
But you shouldn't use your hands to wipe.
I just washed my hands. Actually, I just did.
My sister's getting on my case.
Yeah. I guess I was a wild driver.
Wow. Yeah, it's a good job it was on the course.
Gary, you like our new plate?
Beautiful.
Where's the plate?
I actually brought my own plate.
You did?
Yeah.
A napkin. I meant to throw
some.
Oh,
how good.
It's an important thing.
You get a napkin for
Maddie,
those plates.
Maddie, you're fired.
What's it made of,
Gary?
Call a napkin?
Porcelain?
So how do you know
Glendora? Debbie
decorated it.
Okay.
No!
Let me see it.
I don't think
I was here.
Oh, she did that?
I did.
I said no.
My, that's done good work. What's it made of,
Gary? At night.
It's ceramic.
Ceramic?
It was for
I'm a member of the Postenkill Historical Society.
No, you decorated.
I haven't been in a while.
We decorated these and then they got fired. And it was all for empty bowls. It was like a fundraiser.
No, but I'm not.
You know the empty bowls thing?
Oh.
People donate. Local restaurants from around.
Good.
You know,
You brought a bowl too?
Debbie,
I brought cups in case there were no bowls.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And the silverware can come out.
And your spoons.
Yeah. And here we are.
And some spoons.
Thank you.
So you're going to wait on Glendora?
I didn't see any cars,
I don't know.
The wrong day.
Well, we're downstairs. When it got to 6 o'clock and I didn't see anybody, I thought I had the wrong day.
And you were both mistaken.
Yeah.
Good thing I saw you drive in.
That's right. Let's do this.
I'm going to put this. Do you want somebody to sit here?
Sure. And put the box here in the thing? All right.
No, I got
can
it.
Can I have that, honey, so I can
Isn't
reach
that a
it?
Wonderful color?
Yeah. Thank you.
Beautiful.
I love yellow. It's my favorite color.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
All right. I think
here's some bread, honey.
So
here's well, bread.
Fantastic.
Okay, let
and
me just
some
put these out.
Bread.
What?
Butterscotch.
What's that for?
These are little steak, like steaklets.
It's a confection.
Wow.
And you can put it on bread or just eat it.
Steaklets?
Yeah. Joyce, would you uncover mine?
Sure.
Thanks. And that is Joyce and ours. That is tofu stir fry.
Wow.
Yeah, with cabbage and
wow,
mixed vegetables.
Wow, that looks good.
We'll see.
Where shall I start?
You start anywhere you like. What'd you make, Gary?
As long as
I just made some chili.
Looks like sweet potatoes in there.
Very sweet potatoes.
Here's
bread. How clever.
So that's soup.
I'm going to try the black bean soup.
Okay, me too. That looks really good. So are you vegan or vegetarian or wannabe
vegetarian.
Or vegetarian? For how long?
Since I was about 6 or 7.
Wow. That's impressive.
Many moons.
That's impressive. Did you hear that, Glennie?
What, dear?
She's been vegetarian since she was 6.
No, really? Was that why she has such pretty hair?
Yeah, there you go.
I used to spend weekends with my grandfather who had a farm. And one time I rode with him, didn't know where I was going.
Oh, boy.
With pigs.
Oh, boy.
Tobin's first prize.
Oh,
I can still hear them screaming.
Oh, I don't want to hear.
And I'm an animal person.
Yeah.
Yes, I am too. I'm with you.
And I thought, no.
Good for you. Amazing clarity at 6 years of age.
Mm. I just loved animals.
Shelly,
would you like some soup?
Stuff yourself.
Yes, please.
It's a terrible thing. You know, it's funny because pigs seem to be the catalyst sometimes. I guess because there's so many. The same thing happened. I saw something.
How's the church doing,
on
huh?
A video.
Well, you know, with
and
I was Sunday is a very
church.
Busy night
no
with sport, so we haven't been to church for many weeks.
That's a terrible thing. That's ruining America.
Yes,
so?
I do.
Alrighty.
Sports is too much, Gary.
Thank you.
Thank you, honey.
You're welcome.
What is that?
Black bean soup. That's where we're going
to
start.
I went to that night.
Oh, what happened?
What was that for?
I'll come right over here.
What a nice sweater.
You look nice.
You
wear green for St. Patrick's Day.
He didn't use the microphone.
Oh, dear. These are somebody's photos.
And nobody said hello to me.
Are these photos?
Nobody greeted
me. No, this is one photo.
And it was an empty church. And I knew one woman, Bonnie.
Yeah.
Hi, Bonnie. It's like, was I not supposed to talk afterwards?
She's vegan.
I mean, I didn't know that.
You're not supposed to talk in church?
No, it's here.
The oldest
church.
One I had
I assumed it was proper.
Almost 16.
So
that's a great
I
record.
Wasn't too
I've heard
I've
that.
Had the 19,
do you want some water?
21 and
you know, 22. I brought some water with me,
okay.
Actually.
Well, there's you.
Everybody's seen this, right?
Oh, this.com.
Welcome.
.com, you've
what?
Seen that, Joyce?
Yeah. I saw a person.
Me too.
You're welcome.
I think we should all thank God that we're together.
Thank you.
And that we are trying to do good for the world and for the animals. And we thank God for this magnificent spring weather.
Yes.
And that winter
great.
May be over.
Does Debbie
you know,
do
winter's
pottery
coming
as a
back
regular
next week?
No.
No,
pretty.
No, we're not going to let it.
30s and 40s.
Mm. I can live with that, I think. As long as there's not like a lot of snow.
This is the 39th meeting of the Glendora Vegetarian Club. We're starting our third year. This is the first meeting of our third year.
Oh.
And would you pass these out, Madeline?
Sure.
Mm. What good soup.
Very good.
Delicious.
Who made it?
I did.
Molly.
Who made it? It is good.
I took a nutrition class a year or two ago and it was all plant-based food.
Really?
So I had the recipe. I actually have it with me.
And where was that?
It was
You were hungry,
in
huh?
In Brunswick.
Oh, really? At the library?
No.
I haven't eaten since Debbie left, right? Oh,
where
no,
the
you're
doctors
the
are.
Oh,
where
there.
The doctors are.
Eaten since his
the
wife.
Oh, really? In the medical center?
Down on Long Island.
I was
joking, because he cooks.
I had a sandwich about 11 o'clock.
Mm.
you see.
And one, my instructor was a nutritionist, and she did the classes.
Whoa, well, that'll take care of anything, almost, I think.
Is there a secret ingredient in this black bean soup?
Are we ready for all creatures, folks?
Yeah.
A one, a two, a three.
All creatures of our God and King, lift up your hearts and let us sing. Just be kind, stop the cruel.
The cows and pigs,
leave them alone.
The hares and horses, turkeys too. Just be kind,
save the fish, stop the cruel. One with God, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Is our camera going, huh?
It is. It should be. Gary, would you check it on your way around?
Yes, I will.
Anytime you want to.
Yes, it's definitely going.
Oh. As a matter of fact, I have a very funny story to tell you in a little while.
Okay.
You're going to tell us a funny story?
I told you already.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Tell us a funny story.
Oh, okay. Well, Joyce just said, when can I see some of these videos that we take? And I don't know if you know, Marlene, that Glendora puts these on YouTube and Twitter. Did you know that? She not only puts the videos of not just these meetings, but everyday life. She does a program called A Chat with Glendora, and she makes DVDs, and she sends them out to how many stations?
61
wow. stations. So it takes she and Austin and I 4 days to accomplish that every second month. So you can go on any YouTube to see anything and Public Access TV. And the other night, I'm sitting at 9:45, and I get a call from my brother. And that's very late because he works early in the morning.
And where does your brother live?
He lives down near Middletown. So anyhow, I pick up the phone, and there's my brother and his wife, and they are laughing hysterically. I mean, crying. They're laughing so hard. And I'm like, Carl, what is so funny? And he can barely talk. He's laughing so hard. He says, I've been flipping through TV, and I'm looking at this show, and then I flip the channel, and I'm looking at this other show, and I'm looking at this woman. And he's saying, and I'm saying to myself, that looks like Maddie. And then Sherry comes walking in, and Carl says to her, doesn't that look like Maddie? And Sherry looks at it, and she says, that is Maddie. And they had stumbled across a chat with Glendora on PBS, and there it was.
But you don't know what channel.
No, not down there.
Not,
yeah.
Down there, every channel's different.
Right.
But here, your channel would be channel 18.
I don't get that. Oh. I don't get cable.
We get 17.
You don't get cable.
Yeah.
Well, then you can see it on Facebook, can't they?
I'm no good at that.
And YouTube. So anyhow, they found that very funny.
Yeah, that's very funny.
And the interesting thing was, I said, well, what were we doing?
Uh-oh.
He described this room. It was one of the ones from here.
Oh!
And I said, well, what was I doing? He said, I don't know. I saw you from the back the whole time. And I said, you recognize me from the back?
That's right. You were in
and
the back.
And he said, I didn't recognize you so much from the back as the way that you move. Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
I mean, he's known me his whole life, so that makes sense. But I just thought that was so funny. But they were practically peeing their pants.
I think it's funny, too.
It was hysterical.
Where did those cutlets come from?
Glendora.
So the process?
Yes.
Well, dear,
I can't eat salty foods. My blood pressure went up. And all
it,
this
you,
stuff
you think
is
it's spicy
processed.
Well, no. Salt in it.
Probably have right. salt in it.
No
oh,
salt
I never,
in the chili.
That's a good thing. Well, I never heard of that, Joyce.
What?
I never heard of that. You can't eat processed foods.
The processed foods, they usually have a lot of sodium in them.
Oh, I see.
Right. She probably has the box. You could check it, I suppose.
I've checked all the boxes. They're very high.
Yeah.
So.
Come ye thankful people, come. Raise the song of harvest high. All is safely gathered in, ere the winter storms begin. God our Maker doth provide, for our wants to be supplied. Come to God's own temple, come. Raise the song of harvest high.
Here we go. We don't sing that one very often.
It's nice, isn't it?
Thank you, Marlene. It's Marlene, right? Marlene, I hope.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's Thanksgiving.
It is our clause of the churches.
The churches, I think.
Thank you, dear.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Is the Glendora, do you have the box for the stakelets?
Yo, we have wonderful forks.
No, the box, the stakelets.
Yes, I do.
We don't want to know.
There it is, there it is.
Yep. No, maybe you do want to know.
Here's what they are.
Oh.
Now see, I take that stakelet and I break it up and I put it in the soup.
Yeah.
What, tonight you did that?
No, I'm just saying.
Oh.
Doesn't sound good.
500.
No.
Let's guess. 320. 180.
Wow.
How much?
480.
Oh my.
Per
I
serving?
I was close. I said 520. 500.
I think so.
Oh, it's got egg in it.
Oh, I'm sorry, Joyce. I won't bring stuff like that anymore.
Is it good, Gary? I've never made it before, so.
Fantastic.
No good. I tried something different this time, and I learned a cooking lesson. Normally, I take the tofu and I coat it in.
Can I get you something?
And I coat
yes,
it
honey.
In
whatever
cornstarch,
you get me.
And then I fry
whatever
it.
You get yourself.
This time, I sprinkled the cornstarch over it, and there was the marinating sauce, so it kind of made like a gravy, and it did not make them crispy like I normally make. So,
well, you know what I do? I get a baking sheet, and I cut the slice, you know, if you get the 1 pound block of tofu,
right, pretty
slice it.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
and then, you know, you might want to just put a little cooking spray on the sheet. And then I just put a little soy sauce.
Yes.
Oh!
Good idea.
On the otamari, on the tofu. And then I put it in the oven on 350 for about 15 minutes. And flip it over another 15, 20 minutes.
Right.
And it comes out, you know.
No, I make it too. I do like it like that.
Yeah.
But if you do it the way I just described, it comes out like fried chicken crispy. Which is a different kind of taste. It's good if you're making like crispy orange or something like that. Yeah.
That's good. Mm. You made that one.
It was good.
2 or 3 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, that's lovely. Thank you. See our nice cutlery, Joyce?
Yeah, where'd you get it?
Walmart.
That's what I figured.
No.
Walmart.
You know what you Well, I got.
Hey, Maddie, I don't have chopsticks.
Sorry.
What were you saying, Gary?
We know what you were saying about sport, Glendora. Well, one thing. I mean.
I think
we go a little crazy with sport. You know, the focus is on, you know, especially at the college level.
Is this what you mean?
Yes.
There's way too much commercialization of it, and there's too much money in it.
Looks like.
But one
leftovers
thing that I've
the fridge.
Yeah.
Seen
it could be. No, it
with my daughter playing sport is when the girls are small and they're growing up and they're going to school, it's tremendously empowering for girls.
What, sports?
Yeah.
Yeah,
to play on a team and to have that cohesiveness of a team of girls all working for her.
No question about
it. But I think you know, with the college thing and when they get older and the money that's in sport now.
And it is true, it might lead to a scholarship, but it is so disruptive of your life, particularly the thing about Sunday mornings. Kids don't go to Sunday school anymore.
I know. I was walking in the woods one day and I met a minister. And we talked about that Sunday morning.
Yeah.
The kids all go to play ball. On our day, you went to church. You didn't go play ball. And
so it is today.
It is worse than who have ruined it. Who made this lovely dish?
Oh, that was made of chili, yeah.
Chili.
It's chewy.
Yep.
And did you show the camera a food? Can you see it, camera?
It's
And tell us about your. Go ahead, Gary.
It's vegan and it's oil free, no oil in it.
Really?
And, no salt.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Are you the one that read that we're not supposed to use any oil other than any kind?
Any oil, right?
I've been telling people they don't believe me and they want to know where did I hear it.
How do you fry things, Gary?
Well, we really don't, with a little water and a little. Mm-hmm. I use a little sherry, some, you know, red wine, or a little soy sauce and a little water. Mm-hmm. But you know, you don't get fried, so it's fried, you know.
But people have been telling me coconut oil is the healthier. Oh, no.
And why not coconut oil?
Because all oil is processed food.
They're what?
It's all processed.
It's all processed and it's all...
But if it's cold pressed or cold processed, isn't there a difference? Isn't that better for you?
I don't know. I mean, I just, you know, my the guys, Esselstyn and our friend Campbell, they're dead against oil. And they make a point, you know, specifically of saying there's no good oil, there's no olive oil, coconut oil.
Wow.
You shouldn't be eating any of that.
Joyce and Madeline, tell us about your dish.
Well, I went to China and I bought my cabbage and then I shredded it and brought it over to Maddie and Brainerd.
Yeah. It's just cabbage and frozen stir-fried vegetables.
Well, they have frozen stir-fried.
They do, yes, and it's just the snap peas and onions and carrots and then fried. I did it all in the wok, and then the cabbage, and the tofu is marinated in soy sauce and then fried.
Well, it's delicious. What did you use for your sauce? The marinade.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I didn't know you had a wok.
I never ate tofu.
No.
Never? Oh, wow.
Well, I never thought about it.
It's very healthy for you.
Wow.
That's quite a lot of cooking time, isn't it? Preparation time?
Not really. It takes a while to get the moisture out of the tofu.
Do you press it?
Mm-hmm. But this was very dry tofu.
Oh, what? How come?
I've never seen such dry tofu.
Where'd you get it from?
I don't remember.
Where'd you get the recipe?
Joyce.
Really?
She gave me the idea.
I studied Chinese cooking. That's my specialty.
Oh. I think it's delicious.
You didn't know that about me.
I didn't.
So, Marlene, what about tempeh? Do you eat tempeh? Do you ever buy that? Or eat that?
What is it?
Tempeh.
Same thing. It's tofu.
What do you use for
tofu? It's soybeans that are fermented and it's like in a block.
I drink soy milk.
Do you?
But I never bought tofu or...
Well, up here it's hard to come by.
What is tempeh? What is it?
It's soybeans and they're cooked and pressed, and then believe it or not, they allow the fermented. So it's got like an interesting. They're kind of nutty. It's got a nice texture to it.
It's like a block.
Yeah.
It's thin.
Right.
It's thin. Yeah. You can buy it. It's right in Hannaford.
Hannaford.
And
what department?
Nature's Center.
It's right when you in
by
Hannaford.
The lettuce.
Yeah. Right there. And you can buy one that's like bacon flavor.
They could left
it. And it has to be refrigerated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you do for protein?
I just eat what I want if it's not meat.
There you go.
Cereals. Good protein.
I would
suppose
that everything has protein in it.
Yeah.
You think?
I don't know, because if I don't eat meat, I just eat fruit and veggies.
Does fruit have protein?
I don't know. That's
a little bit.
No, but vegetables do. In fact, animal protein. In fact, nuts have more protein than meat.
I think that the name for the disease, the protein deficiency disease.
Oh, scurvy? No.
No, that's vitamin C.
Right.
I can't remember the
name.
There's a name for protein deficiency, and it's practically. You know, in the US, no matter what you are, it's like unknown. Because our friend Campbell, Dr. Campbell, I think he just turned 82, right?
Wow.
Glendora.
He just turned 82?
82, yeah.
Did he?
This week.
Dr. Campbell, the whole food, plant-based diet.
I think, he said
so
that
many people
it's kind of, how much protein we need about. As an adult is... You know, it's way over. We don't need...
We eat much more than we need.
Yeah,
right.
We don't need, you know, as much as...
I want to hear the recipe for the bean soup.
Mm.
I'll give it to you when I go.
I read a very...
I have it in the bag.
Okay. I read a very, very interesting article that I discussed with Tony. I was hoping he would come tonight. About they're actually growing meat. Did you know that? Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah, I did.
They're growing meat.
How?
I'm not sure I understood everything, so
I know the printing it.
The
3D printing.
No.
Tissue, no.
They're growing meat with the express purpose of stopping the slaughter of animals. These people that are doing it, these scientists. Now, it does come from animal cells, but they're not growing animals. Do you understand what I'm saying? It was fascinating. I don't know how I feel about it yet because I don't know enough about it, but their specific purpose is to stop the deforestation of the earth.
That's right.
And to stop the slaughter of animals. And I just find that...
Are they doing that in our
very
country
hopeful.
Or you don't know?
I'm sorry, I don't mean to be so ignorant about it, but I only read a small part of the article. I think that it's not in our country right now. I'm not sure, but I don't think... I remember reading that they were doing it here.
Was that on TV?
It was on the internet.
There's a prize, isn't there? Is it like $1 million or $3 million?
One piece of bread.
And if you can produce a chicken cutlet that is indistinguishable.
Wow.
Really?
From a real chicken cutlet.
They're getting close.
Do I have a piece of 12-grain bread?
Absolutely.
Joyce, can you eat 12-grain bread?
Can I eat it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Why? We have some.
No, I saw it.
How much salt is in a slice?
I don't know. Would there be a lot of salt?
No.
What,
you know,
bread?
Until my blood pressure goes
salt
up,
and sugar and everything.
I'm having another steak.
Good.
The more processed, the better I like them. Isn't that awful? I love it.
The more processed, because it's...
I'm joking. I'm just saying, until my blood pressure goes up, I'm going to live dangerously.
Hey, we do what we can, right? Now, you know what I was thinking, Glendora?
What, dear?
And everybody. You know when we talk about Loma Linda and the Seventh-day Adventists, or Adventists, as they are called themselves.
Loma Linda, Seventh, Worthington.
Well, you know, they have that. They all live until, you know, a ripe old age, and they're all healthy. And I'm wondering how much of all the... You know, this
processed
kind of
food,
stuff that they eat.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't think they eat them.
No?
Mm-mm.
I think they're agape. Have you ever heard of agape? Agape is fruit, vegetables, nuts, and grains. Maybe hummus.
And beans. And legumes.
And what? Legumes?
Legumes, yeah.
I love hummus.
Mm.
Me too.
Well, we should start a vegetarian restaurant where that gas station is going in. We don't need another gas station.
And we don't need another restaurant or another sandwich place.
Mm. What gas station?
They're talking about
Nassau.
Oh, in Nassau. Wow. It's
Harry, have you come to a meeting before?
Gas station, haven't.
Yeah, I'm going to say, I met you.
It was
I just
here.
Can't remember
in the other
where.
Room.
Okay.
Yep, in the other room.
Then I wasn't here that night.
Then I take back my, it's nice to meet you, and I mean to say it's nice to see you again.
Me too.
You want this melon? It's good.
No, thank you, Glenn. Not a huge bread eater. The sweet potatoes make this perfect,
I have to say. Oh, sweet potatoes.
Because I'm not a huge bean person, so I was able to grab more sweet potatoes than beans. But it has, does it have some kind of protein in it?
Yeah, it's
like
got
crumbles?
The
crumbles? Yeah.
The Borka crumbles.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's another song.
They're vegan.
Oh, you have to be a baritone to sing this with Glendora, though.
Yeah. I'll try to get it started, Will.
When we get good at this, we can do it as a round.
Now, you know, I think the harvest song is like for harvest time, right?
I don't know.
It's a spring now. Are the spring songs that are coming in?
There you go.
You got one,
huh? Yep.
Joyce,
we're going to share.
Okay, let's see if I can do this now.
I don't want to sing.
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Do.
See what I mean?
Do.
I can't go that low.
Let peace begin with me. Let this be the moment now.
With every step I take, let this be my solemn vow.
To take
each moment and live each moment in peace eternally.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me.
You threw me by starting with the second verse.
I know. I don't know why we start with the second verse.
Oh, you want me to go do the first verse?
No, that's fine.
That's really a Christmas song.
It is?
I think so. We sang it always in our Christmas...
Christmas?
Yeah. In our Christmas concerts.
Thanks. You do?
Mm-hmm.
Where's that?
But it could be any time. Here, go one.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they'll stagger it, so...
Let's see what else we got.
You're salty.
I'd like to call your attention again to egg replacers.
Oh, mm-hmm. I love that.
You do?
Where do you get them?
This is made of tapioca root and arrowroot, right?
I think there's potato starch in it as well.
And it's it works very...
It does.
Very well.
Yeah.
I think it's a teaspoon of this to a tablespoon and a half.
Something like
to
that.
Every teaspoon, is that what it is?
I think so.
What equals an egg?
Uh-huh.
One egg.
So you can do that for cakes?
Yeah.
Excuse me, hon. Mm. Oh, yes, you can. Mm-hmm. Wonderfully. If you want to make scrambled eggs, you can do that with tofu.
Yeah. Tofu
scrambled. Oh,
or you can
that.
Also
That's
do it with plantains. Did you ever hear of that, honey? Doing making scrambled eggs with plantains?
I think I did.
Look at her. She cleaned up her plate.
I did. I eat very fast.
Mr. Barkey, Big and Best dog biscuits. And I gave a brand new package of dog biscuits to my 10th grader, neighbor, and asked her to open them to give to her dogs, and her dogs, of course, are wanting it as fast as they can get it. And she pulled and pulled and pulled, and finally,
the dog had all he wanted.
Yes. Okay, I'll pass this group around. This is V-Dog. This is a dog.
Vegan dog food, huh?
Dog food. I recommend this as far as our friend Marlene getting proteins. This protein, this is more than meat, you know, grains.
I love granola.
Am I causing you a...
What? I need my glasses.
Oh. And what else we got? These, what is this, Madeline?
Let's see.
What are these, honey?
Okay, these are Grateful Grahams. They're original Grahams. They're graham crackers.
Mm.
No dairy, no eggs, no soy, no preservatives, no GMOs, high fructose corn syrup.
Sound good, don't they?
Yes. Very good. They have agave nectar in them.
Mm.
And these Red Hots came from the vegan store in Maryland, Rockville, Maryland. This is Big Frank's, which happens to be vegan. It's a hot dog that's vegan. And are you familiar with Gardein, everybody? Gardein?
Yeah.
You can always count on their being vegan.
Gardein? Oh, yeah.
You can always count on their being vegan. And here's a vegan cookie, and it's delicious. And it has a funny picture. See the funny picture?
Oh, yeah. It's like some hippie runs that company.
What's this, Madeline?
This is, mark your calendars, 10 days in the upper room. Something about the church.
Wrong.
Right.
That's from this, the upper room is this church. That's a Methodist church, the upper room. What's this, hon?
Cranberry orange muffin cookie.
Cranberry muffin cookie, I tell you, that was quite good. That came from the vegan store and stuff. And what is this, another Barkey?
Oh. Listen to this. Nearly half of our nation's water supply goes to raising animals. Oh, we're going to talk about that later. Anyhow, this says, for example, it takes 2,400 gallons of water to produce a single pound of meat.
Wow.
It does?
2,400 gallons of water.
Did you hear that, Marlene?
Another issue we should address.
To produce one burger?
90% of deforestation is caused from raising livestock.
Wow.
You know what? I'll bet you money, though. This 5-pound bag cost $30 easily. Easily. You any idea how much this cost?
Well,
I know somebody
right.
must have given it to you, right?
I think you're right. Uh-huh. Folks, this is a... if you're ever missing, you know, Jell-O is made with gelatin, which is made from cow's hooves.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And